This video is part 7 in a series of videos on graphing in Excel 2010. This part, I'll be going over how to make a surface plot, or a 3D plot. On my spreadsheet, I do have an example assignment question. This question states, to create a surface chart for the equation z equals 5x squared minus 4y to the fourth, where x and y are both between negative 2 and 2. To create a 3D plot, you need to have a 3D range of data. Normal plots have a 2D range, the x and the y, in two columns. Now, however, you have an x, y, and a z. Your x and y are both independent variables, so they need to be set up separately. Here, I'm going to put x, which is going in this direction, and y, which is going in this direction. That means the z is going to be left going in this. So now we need to input the information. The x goes from negative 2 to 2. I'm going to do it in range of 0.5. So I have negative 2, negative 1.5, and then I highlight both of these cells and use the fill handle to take it all the way out to 2. And then I do the same here. Negative 2, negative 1.5, and use the fill handle to fill in the rest. That means the equation has to go in this area. The equation is 5x squared minus 4y to the fourth. So I enter the equation equals 5 times the cell above, which is x to the squared, minus 4 times the cell to the left, which is y, to the fourth. So for these two values, that comes out to negative 44. And I can go through and manually type that in for every single one of these cells, but there's an easier way to do this. Here, since I need this to remain row 10 to go through all of the x values, I need to put a dollar sign in front of the 10. This means that when I use the fill handle to change things, the C or the column can change, but the 10, which is the row, cannot. And I need to do the opposite for my y's. I need to make sure that the column B does not change, even though the row 11 is allowed to. So if I press enter again, the value is still negative 44. Now when I use the fill handle, I can drag it down, and it fills in the rest of the way here. So if I select this one, for example, C10 is still the correct location for x, and now B16 is the y, which is the y that's currently next to this selected cell. So if I highlight that arrange again and do the fill column over 1, and let's say select this one, my row is still 10, but my column has changed to D for my x. My y is still B13, so B remains the column, but 13 is the new row. So if I highlight this again and drag it all the way over, it fills in the rest of this. And to make this a little bit easier to read, I'm simply going to format the cells and put a border around these answers. And then now I'm going to put a border around the x's and one around the y's. This way I can see that here are my y's, my x's, and these are the z's. Now to plot this, I highlight my range of z's, go to insert, this circle which is other charts, and I select a surface chart. And this is my chart here. I have to right click and I'm going to move it to its own sheet. I'm going to name it surface. Now you can see that the values are all very small and hard to read, so I'm going to change the font up to 16. The way surface charts work is by color coding. So this blue range here, you can see, is where the chart is in the range of negative 70 to negative 60. The next color up is the range of negative 60 to negative 50, then negative 50 to negative 40, all the way up to here, which is 10 to 20, and only a few locations. Changing surface charts to make them more easy to read or to view is a bit different from using normal 2D charts. So if I right-click and go to Format Chart Area, I have lots of options here. 3D format is where I can change the 3D view of it. So if I want to have beveled edges, it adds that to the outside edge here. So if I change the bevel edge to this, you can see the edge changed here. But I don't really care, so I'm going to turn that off. 3D rotation is really important. If your graph is set in a location where it's hard to see what it's trying to show you, you need to change the 3D rotation. So here I'm going to change the perspective and increase it to 40. Now if I move this out of the way, you can see here that it's actually a lot more difficult to see, view. So I'm taking this back down to 20, 15, 10, 5, and then 0.1, which is the smallest. And that's actually pretty good to view this. if I can change other properties of this, but I think that's all that I want to alter here. So if I close that and go back here, now what I need to do is label these, because I don't know if this is an X or this is the X, although I'm pretty sure this one is the Z. And as you can tell, even though this could be the X or the Y, it goes from 1 to 9, since there were 9 values, instead of negative 2 to 2. To change this, I go to Select Data, and I pick a series. So the series is what's listed along here, which is the y-axis. So this here is my y-axis. And I edit it, and my series name, so this is the first value, goes from C11 to K11. Here, that is my series name. And I have to go through and edit every one of these series that way. And now I have all of these now entered as the series name or the Y value that is associated with that location. So if I look back here, I can see the numbers are now shown where they're supposed to be for the Y axis. Now the X axis still needs to be changed. So if I go to my horizontal axis label and click Edit, and go to Sheet 1 and just highlight the range, select OK, and it changes it for all of them. And now this is now labeled negative 2 to 2 along with this. So I'm going to expand the ribbon and go to Layout. I need to add a chart title, but I'm just going to name it Assignment Question, since there is no specific example associated with this. But I need to add axes titles. So the depth axes title, which is the Y axes, the one along here, I want to have a horizontal title shown there. I want to name it just the Y axes. The vertical, which is my Z axes, is rotated over here, and that's just the Z axes. And my horizontal is simply the x-axis. So even though this particular example does not have anything associated with those axes, it's still important to label which one's which. That way I can see that there seems to be a zero here when this is about negative 0.5, and that's about zero. Although it's still very difficult to view this sort of thing in Excel, and it would be better just to go to the sheet and find out where it's zero. And it's zero where everything else is zero. So surface charts can be extremely useful in Excel, but they're also very difficult to use. In that case, they're not used very often.